Hello everybody, it's the Dancing Squid back here for another video, and we're going to be playing Botany Breakers to start off with me getting back into YouTube after a week's hiatus. We're going to turn off research and development. I don't want any money going towards that until we have more steady income. Play some merry-go-round. You might notice things are running a bit smoother now. I just got myself some new equipment. I got a new laptop, and it's running this game better than my old one did. I've got a blue snowball black ice microphone for better sound quality. And it's running very well. I am actually really happy with this purchase, and I'm glad that I got this computer. It's pretty good specs for the price. You know, it's a budget machine. Sort of. How much is this going to cost me to place there? You always kind of want to have a roller coaster to start out with. I guess roller coasters make a good amount of money. And that's something you really need at the start of a scenario. Actually, do I not have that piece yet? No, I don't. So we're just gonna have. No, actually, no, I'm not gonna allow that. We will not have just randomly floating things in the air. I don't like it when scenery floats in the air. Test that. We do not want to forget the all-important food stalls, because people need to eat. I know when I go to amusement parks I get hungry, so food. And we will open the park. And there we go, that classic merry-go-round music. I still can't believe just how much charm this game has, even like several years after its release. It's a great game, and I highly recommend picking it up. It's actually not that expensive. I don't know why I opened scenery. I want to build another ride. Build this one. It's always popular. A decent amount of guests to start with. They started coming in pretty quickly. I'll open the roller coaster. Somebody actually got on the merry-go-round. Holy cow. Before something breaks down, let's hire some staff. Ah. I always want to make sure your handymen are organized. I'm gonna stop singing now because you guys are probably getting sick of it. Man, these guests are coming in quickly. I was not expecting to have so many. Man, my recording's going well too. Like, dang, I was not expecting my new laptop to be this good. But it was. And you probably just heard that, guys. Sorry. Working with a friend at the moment. Okay, you know what? We will not do that. We're just gonna let things run for a little bit. Try to get some more cash because I do want to build another ride, another track ride. I guess I'm liking the mango muncher. Build a dinghy slide, make it nice, simple, and cheap. Because we do not have the money to build a mega coaster. Because trust me, I would have done that. Too high for supports. I go figure. Suppose this is going to be a terrain-based ride then. I don't mind making terrain-based rides, it's fun. Here's a little extra challenge. Oh geez, didn't leave enough room. But I have to do that. Wrong way. I remember back when I was a kid, I would always just make rides that were a little freaking circle on the ground. It was really, really lame, but I was a kid, I didn't know better. Whoops. This park is going to be really compact and really tight, at least at the start of it, because, actually, I don't care. Oh, whoops. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. I should have been using the path tool. Can I make the... Actually, that might work. What's in the footpath? Dang it, footpath. Why are you in my way? That moment when you realize you've picked the absolute worst location to build a ride. Yes. This is annoying. These are the steps to success, my friend. There we go. Finally. Now I have to put a do not enter sign so people don't go down the exit like a bunch of freaking dinguses. I also take handyman number 3, plop him down there. And we'll test the dinghy side. Make sure it doesn't crash. Because if you don't build these rides properly and manage the ride vehicle momentum, these things will crash. They will crash. There are no ifs, ands, or buts. They will crash if you don't do it right. Oh, seems I got it pretty much spot on. Not too shabby for the first dinghy slide of the Dancing Squid. Well, let's make it a bit more exciting. I can add a little dip here. Which I can't. I hope you didn't see that. If you did, that was just me checking the response I got from the Bristol Motor Speedway. I'm going to be appearing at Bristol Motor Speedway, not as a guest, because, you know, as cool as that would be, I'm not that cool. You know, I'm not Phil Swift. I'm not challenging the gods with flex tape. Kind of cool. Phil Swift is just a freaking meme. Well, guys, I think I'm going to end it off here. This has been a good episode, and hopefully it's been good to watch. I'd like to thank you all for watching, and if you enjoyed, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe. Hit the bell icon if you want to see any future episodes or any future videos from the Dancing Squid. I will be starting to do different games now that I have new equipment. Anyways, thank you all for watching. I hope y'all enjoyed. This is the Dancing Squid. I'll see you in the next one.